Now this is patient wanting to self discharge, and this is a patient Miss Newman, and she was admitted with the meningitis, Listeria monocytogenes, and she was giving advice 3 weeks IV antibiotics, and she recovered. She is doing very fine, but still the course is not completed, and she wants to go home. She wants self discharge, and she has number of reasons that she has 2 children in the home. Small children, and she doesn't like the food, she doesn't like the attitude of nursing staff, and like these concerns she has. So but the nurse has asked you to speak to her not to go and stay here in the hospital till she completes a course of IV antibiotic. Now your task is ascertain why Miss Newman wants to discharge herself, and discuss why it would be best to stay and offer alternatives if she refuses to stay. Okay, so like in every skill we are doing introduction, checking, identification, purpose, agenda, understanding. Okay, so hello, good morning, I'm Dr. Ace, one of the doctor in the medical ward. Are you Miss Newman? Okay, nice to meet you ma'am. Well, I understand that you are admitted with some infection of the coverings of the brain. This I have explained meningitis, okay, because meningitis is a jargon, you have to speak in the layman language, infection of the coverings of brain, and you are being treated for that through the medication giving through the blood channels of your arm. Is that okay? Okay, so I'm here to discuss with you about your condition, as well as the sister told me that you want to speak to me regarding going home. Is that correct? Correct. Okay, so will you tell me about your concerns? Now she will tell you her problems, like the same problem which I have mentioned before, like she is doing fine, so she wants to go home, number one. Number two, she has 2 small kids at the home. Number three, she doesn't like the attitude of some nursing staff, and number four, she doesn't like the food. Now you have to manage all of her concerns within ethics, softly, politely, and provide solution to every of her concern, and also keep on expressing concern on her every concern. Okay, so now you keep on explaining like this, then tell her that okay, I appreciate your concern, I can understand, and this and this. Then tell her that but I feel that it's wise for you to stay in the hospital with us. And now first of all, you tell the importance of IV antibiotic, that why it is important. You can tell little bit, make her scared of this meningitis, and tell her that this infection, it can be serious, and if you will not get proper and full treatment, and also you can infect others, and you can tell that she can have many complications of meningitis if not treated properly. As we know that meningitis is causing nerve palsies and even stroke and different types, different meningitis and headache and like this. Little bit make her scared so that she thinks of staying in the hospital and thinks to take the full course of 3 weeks of IV antibiotics. Okay, and then if tell her she's concerned about her 2 kids in the home, then tell her that if you will go like this, then if you are not like this, you are not completely recovered, and still the course is not completed, then you may infect your kids at the home, and also you can your sister is there, and you can talk any other of your relative to be here, or any other caretaker to help your sister to take care for your kids. Okay, and tell her if she says that if she doesn't like the food, then you can tell her that we can appoint someone to bring food for you from the home. And also tell her that I will can speak to the nursing staff home attitude you don't like, and if she's disturbed about cannula insertion, then you can tell her that I can do it for you. So you have to make every possible effort for her to stay in the home, in the hospital. But if still she is determined to go, then remind her, okay, if still you want to go, then you have to take the responsibility for your own care in this situation, and she need to advise to sign a formal statement outlining that she has been advised that she is taking her own discharge against medical advice. If she is not willing to do so, then don't make a fuss, okay? Agree with her and explain that, okay, I will make entry in the notes that what has happened and your reasons for leaving and the advice which was given to you, okay? I will write everything. And if still she insists that she wants to go home now, then tell her that I request you to wait till I can talk with the consultant for the infectious diseases, and so that as we are giving you medication through the blood channel, so that when you will be in home, it will be difficult for you to take the medication through blood channel, so I can write some tablets for you and only he can inform. So for some time it's wise to wait, okay? And then do the NGU recap, patient recap, and advice sports follow-up and helps. And there are some things important which I want to tell you in this scenario. Some patient is also disturbed about sleep deprivation, so okay, this is sometime patient want to move because of this, so if they express their concern, you have to manage it. And also patient cannot be kept against their will, especially if they don't show signs of psychiatric illness which could impair their capacity to make a decision. Then it is a doctor's responsibility to inform them of the importance of staying, as we did, and that the patient will be taking full responsibility for their self-discharge, okay? And and you have to make specific follow-up arrangements, like the patient who choose for self-discharge, don't punish them for doing so, okay? If they require medication, then it needs to be provided. And specific follow-ups is necessary. Also it is advisable to inform your consultant as well as a patient's GP to be notified promptly, so that if the patient falls ill again, then the GP will be aware of the prior situation. And also it is prudent to try and advise the patient about what they need to do so if they feel unwell or worse when they get home, and how are there situations in which patient's mental status assessed before deciding that they have capacity of self-discharge or not. These are situations when patients are under the influence of alcohol or drugs, patient admitted with acute or chronic confusional states including delirium, those with a diagnosed or suspected mental health illness that could impair their decision making capacity, and children under the age of 16. So in such patients, if they want to self-discharge themselves, then you don't have to agree with them, and you have to assess their capacity. And again, it will be a team decision. Don't decide on your own. Always inform the make a team. Like, you can discuss with your consultant, with the consultant of infectious diseases, and with the consultant and with the neurologist, and with the nursing staff, and with the patient relatives, and involve all members and then decide, okay? Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you.